What is going on, everybody? Today I'm sharing a piece of knowledge on how to detect if time settings are off your Windows or Linux machine. I mean, detect if the clock has been gone crazy. Dependencies for the project? Of course, you need a Zabbix server, at least version 4.2. Time settings must be correct on master server and all your Zabbix proxies. What gives this approach a special value is that it's designed to work on the cases where agent active checks are the only option. And let's remind ourselves that active checks are the best checks in the world because agent is pushing information to the server and server is doing nothing but accepting incoming data and calculating triggers. How everything works. The template consists with three items. Only one item is gathering data. This is master item. The master item is utilizing a Zabbix agent and collecting what is a local time of this machine. Magic happens inside a preprocessing section where the JavaScript already is calculating what is the difference between server and agent. This is possible because JavaScript is executed on the backend server, and you know, JavaScript engine knows already what is the correct time. If the clock of the agent machine is running in the future, then the reported metric will be a negative number. This negative number cannot be stored inside the integers or float table, so I will store this information as character. Going back to items, I have also two dependable items. One item will use input from master item and determine what is the offset. To see the details in the preprocessing section, we can notice that it's grouping together all digits as one number. Going back to items and the definition of the second item, this will again use the input data from master item and it will determine if agent time is shifting in the future or in past. This is done by detecting if the string contains a minus sign or not. Quite funny preprocessing here, we are replacing all digits with nothing and then counting the length of the string. Let's click a test button to show what I mean by that. Type in some integer, test now. The answer is zero, because no minus is there. If we change the input string to start with minus, then the output will be one. If we add some letter to string, the output will also count all the letters. In the trigger section, there are two triggers. One will fire up if agent time goes nuts in future. The second trigger is identifying the past situation. The template itself has been designed to be applicable out from the box without changing anything. But if you want to badly change at least something, then one variable can be adjusted in the macro section. This is the default threshold for the trigger. The problem will be generated if the time difference is more than 2 minutes. Now I will apply this template to a host. We'll use the search field to pick the host. Go to Configuration, Templates tab, add the template. Update. To speed up this demonstration, I will modify the item update interval. Here inside the host configuration section, I can open the template right away by clicking on it. Open items, open my only master item and set update interval to 1 second. Enter. There is a possibility to even speed up the calculation of triggers by replacing the currently used trigger function min with trigger function last plus argument hashtag one, which referencing the very recent value of an item. Of a metric, but yeah. By the way, the function min was installed here to eliminate false positive triggers. It should remain that way when running in production. Update. Second trigger. Replace min with last with the argument hashtag one. Update. Everything now is pre-cooked. Now reloading configuration cache of master server. And to instantly report back metrics, I will restart agent. But before that, I will also configure to report back everything every 1 second instead of 5 seconds, which is the default buffer. Now I will open agent configuration, search for keyword buffer, and set the value to 1. Restart agent. 1 second later, I check the latest data page and I see that I see what is the time difference and what is the position of time shifting. Either the time has been shifted away. No, the time has been shifted away only few seconds. And second metric is representing what is the direction. Either the shifting is happening in the either time goes in the future or time goes in the past. All right, now from the command line, I will check what time is it now by running command date, and now we will shift the clock somewhere 5 minutes back. Enter. Checking the time again, the clock is running 5 minutes ago. Now to the latest data page. Refresh. 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 It looks like nothing is working. Well, this is according to plan. This is because the agent now is reporting metrics in the past, and the latest data page has been designed in a way to represent content very close to the server time. We can actually see how the metrics are inserted in the past period by opening the graph. We'll open graph in a new tab, filter out last 15 minutes. Here we can see some dots are inserted exactly 5 minutes ago. What can we do? We can wait 5 solid minutes till the old data will become the only recent data, or I can clear the item history. To clear item history for multiple items from the latest data page, a very reliable way is to click on a hostname and select configuration. I will open it in new tab, open items, filter out application time, select all items and hit clear history. Now going back to the latest data page, refresh the page. The time shift instantly is represented correctly, which is 5 minutes in the past. This means the trigger should be already in the problem state. Let's check it out. A very reliable way to open problems from this particular host is to click on the host and select problems. I will open this in new tab. Yes, the problem is there, but the event title is quite old. This is by design. if the metric was reported in the past, then the event will be generated in the past. If there are a lot of problems per this host, you need to create a separate dashboard to browse these kind of records. Let's create this dashboard. Dashboards, create a new dashboard. Dashboard title crazy. Inserting a new widget. Widget type problems. It is crucial to select problem mode problems instead of recent problems. Otherwise, if the agent clock runs quite in the past, like a year ago, most likely you will never notice those records. The keyword for the trigger must be agent time in, which can be in past or future. As additional details, we will set the operational data to be represented to see exactly how many minutes the agent time has shifted away. Let's reset the time and test the second use case when the agent time is configured in future. This is Linux machine running Debian 10. To synchronize my time, here I can restart NTP daemon, systemctl restart NTP, and usually it takes 10 fucking seconds to get my time correct. Let's wait. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Running date again. It's now correct. Next thing, I will set the time in the very future. Time date CTL set minus time. And now the clock, it will be 22 minutes past the hour 22 and also 22 seconds. Enter. Checking clock again, the time is in future. Go to Zabbix dashboard. It shows an appropriate event. This is a total success. Alright, that was all I wanted to show today. If you found this video helpful, hit the like button. And as always, thanks for watching. And the template is available in the video description.